Welcome back. So this is part 3 where we will discuss about security options which are available in autonomous transaction processing databases. So in terms of security, only databases which are basically exposed to users is SQL access only. So that prevents installing or modifying any software on the system. So no highly privileged access, so no root as well as sysdba. No loggings are allowed to operating system or container database, so no call out to OS is allowed here. So security configuration is deployed at all the level, not only database but network as well as operating systems. So database runs in customer private virtual cloud network that prevents any kind of network access by external users. Public IP is not a requirement here. Network encryptions are available and databases are always encrypted, so that way we are able to reduce the attack surface for operating system and database. Automatic protection of customer data from Oracle operation staff, and this is very, very important as we are the only vendor basically who provide this kind of security feature. So think of like we are providing you autonomous kind of behavior, means we are patching the database systems, we are looking at if any security vulnerabilities are there. But at the same time, the requirement is we should not be able to, or operations should not be able to look into the customer data. And that is implemented through Oracle's own technology. So that is part of Oracle Kernel Database Vault. So that's a security option within databases, and these help you implement these kind of operational control. From the security perspective, so protection of any end user data from customers or administrators, so segregation of roles as well as responsibilities are in place, and it is database vault user realms can be configured here. Oracle automatically applies the security updates for the entire stack, so whether it's a quarterly or off cycle for any kind of high impact security vulnerabilities. Customer can separately use Database Vault for their own user data isolation because it's part of database kernel. And within DBA roles, you can have developer roles or maybe depending on the departments and also if you want to have more controls, and you can use Database Vault. We'll look at the high availability options which are available in autonomous transaction processing database. This offering basically automatically protects from all kind of downtime failures. That includes, like, it has Exadata plus machine learning, AI, you have real application clusters. For site outages, it uses Active Data Guard, which will be coming soon. Right now, it is not available in the current release. For maintenance related activities, real application cluster, rolling updates, as well as transparent application continuity. So they help. In terms of managing changes, you have online indexing or edition-based redefinition. They are getting done. And these are all online operations, so that definitely deal with your downtime requirements. And you, in case of any user errors, you have Flashback database, which is part of this deployment, or Flashback database tables or queries. So they deal with the user errors. Exadata and Rack is definitely for hardware level, no single point of failure, as well as a real application cluster is known to provide scalability and high availability. It follows Oracle maximum availability architecture, so that is Oracle best practices blueprint, and based on those proven Oracle high availability technologies, based on expert recommendations as well as customer experience. The goal of maximum availability architecture is to achieve basically optimal high availability for Oracle customers, at the same time looking at lowering the cost as well as the complexity. It also provides zero impact patching that enables patching of Oracle grid infrastructure as well as database software without basically interrupting the database operations. So patches will be applied out of place and in a rolling fashion, with one node being patched at a time while the database instance on other node is up and running. So that way it provides zero impact patching, and it uses real application cluster behind the scene. So in terms of serverless, fully automated daily backups to Oracle storage cloud, basically object storage buckets, on also provides on-demand backups, flash back to 24 hours. So these are cool features which are even available on serverless deployments. And dedicated adds some extra features like backup of archive logs, which are performed every hour. So maybe in future we will come up with 15 minutes time interval when we release the new enhancements. Retention time for container database backups is configurable, like anything between 7 days to 60 days. So currently on-demand backups retention is same as container database. Indefinite retention is supported. Zero data loss recovery cloud service will be used for backups maybe in future. So that will provide a different level of backup recovery, service level agreements and enhancements. So in terms of high availability, as it provides protection from the hardware failures or software crashes or software updates, it uses real application cluster database, application continuity, flashback database, redundant network, triple mirrored storage, as well as daily backups. And on top, like extreme performance or extreme availability adds protection from site outages as well as data corruptions. So that you will be seeing like coming maybe in future releases in this. So that is going to use Active Data Guard for standbys. And so backups are fully automated, daily backup as well as on-demand backups are getting done as of today. And uptime requirements are 99.95% of uptime. That is translates to basically 22 minutes of downtime per month. So many new things which is coming up in coming releases. So in terms of RTO and RPO metrics, so high availability policy, recovery time objective, as well as potential data loss, that is nothing but RPO service SLOs, service level objectives. So in terms of disk, network, or storage failure, the downtime or RTO is zero. That is all because it has no single point of failure. Potential data loss is zero. Rack instance failures within seconds you will have, because everything is rack is active, so it doesn't take time. Data loss, there is zero data loss. Rack server failures could be in seconds to data loss is zero. Data corruption or any unrecoverable database availability domain or regional failures, so that is time to restore and recover from cloud object storage. So that's the RTO. And in terms of potential data loss, so since last backup, so maximum 45 minutes based on archive backup frequency. Hardware and software maintenance and updates, so downtime is again zero, as well as potential data loss is zero. Major database upgrades could be hours to zero in terms of RTO, and there is no data loss. Now we are going to take a look at some of the unique feature which is available on Autonomous Dedicated. So one is customized software updates and patching. And Oracle is responsible for all software updates operations. Database is continuously available to applications, and updates applied rolling across rack nodes basically and Exadata storage servers. Application using application continuity, that is the best practice to run without any interruption. And any quarterly patches or updates of all the components, so on demand for critical security issues, that is there on dedicated. So firmware, operating systems, storage, network, any hypervisor or clusterware database, so they all are covered as part of quarterly maintenance schedule. Updates are automatically scheduled based on customer preferences. Like customer can adjust basically timing to accommodate the critical business periods, or customer choose the target software, whether current or any previous quarterly update or revision, and based on their selection only, they're able to control it. So this picture shows like how it appears in the OCI console. Customers has full control on, so automatic maintenance occurs every quarter, and Oracle notifies with exact date and time for maintenance a few weeks in advance. But customers are still able to configure this maintenance schedule. You can either go with no preference, or you go with a specific schedule. So you choose the preferred month, week, or weekday, or the start time for infrastructure maintenance, and then you need to click the update maintenance schedule, and you can confirm the changes. So it appears maintenance history is available in the console itself. So inside maintenance history tab, it will show you if there are any planned maintenance activity or during next 15 days or like any history of whatever operations you have performed so far. We'll move to part 4 of Autonomous Database Dedicated. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in part 4, where we'll talk more on developer tools and productivity options available in Autonomous Dedicated. Thanks for watching.